read these particular verses from the Chaitanya Charitamrita, where Mahaprabhu is in the same mood of the gopis at Ras Lila, and he quoted this same verse in Madhya Lila when he was teaching Sanatana Goswami, and later in the very end of his life, I mean, let's say end of his past Prakat Lila in Sri Puridam. So we can read that because it's very beautiful. It's not very many verses. I can read that. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Anti Lila, chapter 15, verse 61 through 69. So what has happened, it's Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has entered a garden, and he spent in that garden, like this, Bagicha, he became absorbed in Braja Gopi Bhav. And in the ecstasy of Srimati Radharani's Mahabhav, Mahaprabhu glorifies the magnificent beauty of Madhava, Sri Krishna. It's very interesting. We were speaking earlier about this famous verse about Krishna's protection, or killing, whatever, Rake Krishna Marake. And devotees said, well, this is some Bengali, this is also some Hindi mixed. So this we also see, apparently whoever coined that phrase maybe came from Bengal, who after living in Braj Mandal for a while, picked up some Hindi phrases. Because we see the same idea in many of our books, some of our padakartas or our devotees, acharyas, are writing Shastra and Sanskrit, but then they sometimes mix the Sanskrit or the Bengali with Hindi. And Krishna's Kaviraj is one of those, can't say victims, but he's one of those persons that combines the Hindi with the Bengali, and you're going to hear it right now. Verse 60, Anti Lila 3, verse, chapter 15, verse 60. Kahan. Because Bengali, Kahan is a Hindi, it means where. And in Bengali, it would be Kotai. Kotai go prema mahi, radhe radhe, ekbar radhakunme, dake, radhe radhe, abar shamakunda dake, radhe radhe. Kotai, Kotai. So he says, Kahan gela Krishna, this is Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is Krishna in a Bangla Vasha, but he's speaking in Hindi. Kahan, because he also visited Braj Mandal for 2 months, and he traveled all around Braj Mandal with the Sanadiya Brahman from Mathura, and he took so much Madhukari from them, so maybe he picked up a lot of the phrases. Kahan gela Krishna ekani payano darashan, tahan so sundarya mora harela netraman. Prabhu said, where has my Krishna gone just now? I saw him just now, and his beauty has captivated my eyes and mind. Sundarya, Darshan Sundarya, Sham Sundar, Radha Sham Sundar, Harila Netraman, Mora Harila Netraman. Krishna Hari, he's stolen my eyes and my mind. Puna Kene Nadekia, Morali Vandan, Tanhar Darshana Lobe, Brahma Maya Nayan. Why can't I again see Krishna holding his flute to his lips? I saw him under the tamal tree. I ran in that direction, then he disappeared. Oh, my eyes are wandering in hopes of seeing once more. Darshana Lobe, Brahma Maya Nayan. Darshana Lobe, Brahma Maya Nayan. Brahma Maya Nayan. His eyes are wandering. Krishna plays hide and seek with Krishna. Krishna plays hide and seek with devotees. He shows himself and then he disappears. And he shows himself in a variety of ways. He shows himself by utsaha, utsaha mayi. Krishna enters the heart and mind of the new devotee and fills them with enthusiasm to get up early and chant and read all the books. And then after some time, that enthusiasm disappears. And slow down a little bit. So this is the idea. that even Krishna as Mahaprabhu, he's experiencing, oh Krishna, I'm in Radha Bhava, I'm a devotee. The ideal devotee is Radharani, and Krishna sometimes appears to her and sometimes disappears. It's called Lukaluki, Lukaluki Leela. Hide and seek. So Mahaprabhu is experiencing it. Enter the garden, feeling great separation. Oh, where's Krishna? Then had a momentary darshan. Then Krishna disappeared. And then lamentation.